Welcome once again, everyone, to this week's Race to AA's Current Affairs Group. I hope everybody is doing great. Let's look at some of the most important current events that has happened between 5th and the 17th of May. The first one is regarding India's protest over Pakistan government's attempt to hold elections in the disputed area of Gilgit-Baltistan. You can see the area of Gilgit-Baltistan in this image, and you can see that it comes under the disputed areas of Jammu and Kashmir. Since the authority over that area is disputed by both India and Pakistan, Pakistan's present move to hold elections in that area is being seen as a threat to India's sovereignty by the Indian government. As a protest measure, the Indian government has issued a demarche to protest what it called Pakistan's attempt to make material changes to the disputed area by bringing federal authority to Gilgit-Baltistan, which has functioned as a provincial autonomous region since 2009. A demarche simply means a letter of protest issued officially by one country to another. India has rightful claim over the area because Pakistan-occupied Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan are both part of the state of Jammu and Kashmir, which is an integral part of India by virtue of its accession to India in 1947. The next news item is regarding Bharat Market, which is a national e-commerce marketplace launched by Confederation of All India Traders or CAIT. It aims to sell the products of millions of retailers all over India through this online platform, just like Amazon or Flipkart. It would be launched for all retail traders nationwide and aims to integrate 95% of retail traders on board the national platform. CAIT is expecting to enroll around 1 crore retailers in the national platform in the year 2020, hence making it the world's largest and most unique e-marketplace ever. The next is regarding the award of GI tag to the delicious Kovilpatti Kadalamithai of Tamil Nadu. Many of you might have tasted this sweet already. The candy is produced from groundnuts and organic jaggery obtained from specific locations. Water from the river Tamirabharani is also used to enhance its taste. It gets its unique flavor from the use of the special Thani jaggery. While regular jaggery is brown, hardened and sold in round lumps, this is fresh, pale and in soft triangular blocks. The origins of this sweet goes back to 1940s. In the 1940s, Ponnambala Nadar, a grocery store owner in the town, decided to use sugarcane jaggery and peanuts to make the Kadalamithai. He also introduced the cutting of the candy into rectangular shapes instead of the traditional balls. This then became the famous Kovilpatti Kadalamithai that we know today. The next is regarding Operation Samudra Setu, launched by Indian Navy to repatriate Indian citizens from overseas due to COVID-19 pandemic. Samudra Setu literally means sea bridge. The two ships that have embarked on this mission are Indian naval ships Jalashwa and Magar. A total of 1,000 persons are planned to be evacuated during the first trip. This operation is being progressed in close coordination with the Ministries of Defense, External Affairs, Home Affairs, Health and various other agencies of the Government of India and the state governments. The next is regarding washable mask developed by an IIT Delhi startup called NanoSafe Solutions. It is an antimicrobial and washable face mask called NSafe. The mask is reusable up to 50 launderings, thus greatly cutting down the cost of the use. NSafe mask is a triple layered product consisting of inner hydrophilic layer for comfort, middle layer having antimicrobial activity and outermost layer having water and oil repellent behavior. NSafe mask has 99.2% bacterial filtration efficiency along with breathability and splash resistance. The next is regarding global celebrations on Buddha Purnima, also known as Vesak. Ministry of Culture, Government of India, in collaboration with the International Buddhist Confederation or IBC, a global Buddhist umbrella organization, is holding a virtual prayer event this year with the participation of all the supreme heads of the Buddhist sanghas from around the world. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is also set to participate in this year's event, which is planned to be conducted virtually due to the prevailing COVID-19 pandemic. The festival commemorates the birth, enlightenment, and death of Gautama Buddha. Some more details of the festival is given in the slide. Those who want can pause the video and read it. Next news item is regarding Iran's new currency named Toman. Iran's currency until this time was called Irani Rial. With the introduction of new currency, the denomination of it also has been changed. What was previously 10,000 rials will now become 1 toman under the plans. which were approved by the Iranian parliament. Now, why is Iran renaming and revaluating their currency? It is because of the fact that the value of its national currency has been declining steadily since the Islamic Revolution brought the religious government in power in 1970. That drop has accelerated in recent years as harsh US sanctions battered the country's economy. The next is regarding Vande Bharat mission to bring stranded non-resident Indians back home in the wake of COVID-19 crisis. The first flight carrying those stranded in the Gulf countries as part of the Vande Bharat mission in the wake of a global lockdown following the COVID pandemic landed at the Cochin International Airport from Abu Dhabi at 10:08 p.m. on Thursday. It brought 177 adult passengers and 4 children home. The passengers include 48 pregnant women also. The next is regarding Surakshit Dada Dadi and Nana Nani Abhiyan, which is launched by Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog has virtually launched a campaign in association with the Piramal Foundation to protect senior citizens during COVID-19. This newly launched campaign aims to ensure the well-being of senior citizens during the COVID-19 pandemic. The next is regarding Shekhatkar Committee report. The Shekhatkar Committee was set up by former Defence Minister Manohar Parikar for the purpose of defence reforms. The committee was headed by retired Lieutenant General D.B. Shekhatkar. The key recommendations of the committee included making leaner, cohesive and modern armed forces. It had also recommended that India's defence budget should be in the range of 2.5 to 3% of the GDP, keeping in mind possible future threats. Further recommendations of the committee are given in the slide. Those who want can pause the video and read. The next is regarding Vishakhapatnam gas leak incident. The tragedy involves the leakage of poisonous styrene gas from a chemical plant in the area. Styrene gas, which is toxic in nature, may cause irritation to the skin, eyes, and cause respiratory problems and other medical conditions. It is extremely harmful to both life and environment, and its damaging effects are given detailedly in the slides. Those who want can pause the video and write. The next is regarding World Migratory Bird Day. It is observed every year on 9th May and the theme of this year is Birds Connect Our World. It is organized by a collaborative partnership among two UN treaties, that is the Convention on Migratory Species or CMS and the African Eurasian Migratory Waterbird Agreement or AEWA and the Colorado-based non-profit organization Environment for the Americas or EFTA. The UN-led campaign aims to raise awareness of migratory birds and the importance of international cooperation to conserve them. The next is regarding Stringency Index. So the Stringency Index is created by Oxford University and it shows how strict a country's measures were regarding COVID-19 resistance and at what stage of the spread it enforced these measures. It involves a team of 100 Oxford community members who have continuously updated a database of 17 indicators of government response. These indicators examine containment policies such as school and workplace closings, public events, public transport, stay-at-home policies, etc. This slide provides some more details regarding the index. Those who want can pause the video and read. The next is regarding human monoclonal antibodies. They are expected to neutralize SARS-CoV-2 or COVID-19 virus in the COVID-19 patients. The project is to be taken up by the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research or CSIR. The project will be implemented by the National Center for Cell Sciences or NCCS, IIT Indore and Predomics Technologies Private Limited with the Bharat Biotech International Limited as a commercialization partner. The next news item says that Indian Army confirms India-China face-off at the border with minor injuries to both sides. The confrontation took place in North Sikkim on Saturday. India and China have a long-standing border dispute that led to a war in 1962. The hostility causes around 400 face-offs every year along the line of actual control, that is the India-China border. This slide and the last slide contain the name and location of some of the important passes along the border of India. Those who want can pause the video and read. The next news item is regarding infant mortality. So what do you mean by infant mortality rate or IMR? It is the number of deaths of children under 1 year of age per 1,000 live births. According to the data released by the Registrar General of India, the IMR or infant mortality rate in India in 2018 stood at 32. Among the states, Madhya Pradesh has the worst infant mortality rate in the country, while Nagaland has the best infant mortality rate in the country. The next is regarding an automated ultraviolet system or UV system developed by the Research Center Imarat, which is a premier laboratory under DRDO. The device is an automated contactless UV sanitization cabinet called a Defense Research Ultraviolet Sanitizer or DRUS. It has been designed to sanitize mobile phones, iPads, laptops, currency notes, check leaves, challans, passbooks, paper envelopes, etc. The DRUS cabinet is having a contactless operation, which is very important to contain the spread of virus. The proximity sensor switches clubbed with the drawer openings and closing mechanism makes its operation automatic and contactless. It provides 360 degree exposure of UV radiation to the objects placed inside the cabinet. Once the sanitization is done, the system goes in sleep mode, hence the operator need not wait or stand near the device. The next is regarding National Technology Day, which is observed on 12th May to signify the glorious achievements of Indian science and technology. It was on this day in 1998 that India successfully carried out nuclear tests in Rajasthan's Pokhran. On the same day, India also performed a successful test firing of the Trishul missile and had test flown the first indigenous aircraft, Hansa 3. The next news item is regarding yet another mission undertaken by Indian Navy under Mission Sagar. India aims to help countries in the Indian Ocean region like Maldives, Mauritius, Madagascar, Comoros and Seychelles, which are suffering from COVID-19 pandemic. The ship will deliver consignments of COVID-related essential medicines to these countries and about 600 tons of food items to the Maldives. In addition, in the case of Mauritius, a special consignment of Ayurvedic medicines is also being sent. The operation is being progressed in close coordination with the Ministries of Defense and External Affairs and other agencies of the government. The deployment is in consonance with the Prime Minister's vision of security and growth for all in the region or Sagar. The slide provides in details of the Sagar mission. Those who want can post it and read. The next news item says that India may miss its nutrition targets by 2025, according to the Global Nutrition Report of 2020. According to the Global Nutrition Report 2020, India will miss targets for all four nutritional indicators for which there is data available, which are stunting among under 5 children, anemia among women of reproductive age, childhood overweight, and exclusive breastfeeding. India is identified as among the three worst countries, along with Nigeria and Indonesia, for steep within-country disparities on stunting, where the levels are varied fourfold across the communities. This slide gives the details regarding Global Nutrition Report. Those who want can post the video and read. The next is regarding the award of GI Tag to Zorai Kowar painting of Jharkhand and a Telia Rumal of Telangana. The Zorai Kowar painting is a traditional and a ritualistic mural art being practiced by local tribal women during local harvest and marriage seasons using local naturally available soils of different colors in the area of Hazaribagh district of Jharkhand. The Zorai Kowar painting is primarily being practiced only in the district of Hazaribagh. The style features a profusion of lines, dots, animal figures and plants, often represented using religious iconography. The Telia Rumal cloth involves intricate handmade work with a cotton loom displaying a variety of designs and motifs in the three particular colors, which are red, black and white. Telia Rumal can only be created using the traditional handloom process and not by any other mechanical means, as otherwise the very quality of the Rumal will be lost. The next is regarding the economic stimulus package announced by the Prime Minister in the backdrop of economic crisis due to COVID-19 pandemic. The PM has announced an economic package of 20 lakh crore rupees, which is roughly equivalent to 10% of India's GDP. The PM gives a call for self-reliant India and laid down five pillars of Atmanirbhar Bharat, which are economy, infrastructure, system, vibrant demography and demand. This slide provides the details regarding the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. Those who want can pause the video and read. The next news item says that the integrated battle groups will soon be operational. So it is a new concept by Indian Army. The integrated battle groups or IBGs are brigade-sized, agile, self-sufficient combat formations which can swiftly launch strikes against adversary. Each IBG would be tailor-made based on threat, terrain and task, and resources will be allotted based on the three T's, which are threat, terrain and task. They will be available to mobilize within 12 to 48 hours based on the location. As part of the overall force transformation of the army, the IBGs will be operationalized very soon. Next is regarding the Champions Portal launched by Union Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. It is a technology-driven control room cum management information system. The Champion stands here for creation and harmonious application of modern processes for increasing the output and national strength. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman announced the features for the first part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. We had just learned about Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan launched by the Prime Minister, right? As the first part of the scheme, the Finance Minister has announced certain packages for small businesses, for employees and taxpayers, for infrastructure sector and for financial sector. The details are given in the slides. Those who want can pause their video and read. Now, as the second part of Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, the Finance Minister has announced relief packages for migrant workers, Mudra Shishu loanees, and street vendors. For the benefit of migrant workers under One Nation One Card scheme, 67 crore beneficiaries of the ration cards in 23 states can now use their PDS or public distribution system cards or ration cards in any state in India. Relief of almost ₹1,500 crores is being announced to Mudra Shishu loanees, and ₹10,000 as capital is to be provided to nearly 50 lakhs street vendors. The next news item talks about a proposal by Indian Army to recruit civilians for 3-year tour of duty. The proposal is stated to be an attempt to tap the feeling of the youths who do not want to join the army as a profession but wish to experience the military life for a temporary duration. If approved, it will be a voluntary engagement and there will be no dilution in selection criteria. Initially, 100 officers and 1,000 men are being considered for the recruitment as a part of test bedding of the project. Under the new proposal, people to be recruited under the TOD scheme for 3 years, however, will be eligible to be deployed as combatants in key forward locations and there will be no restriction in their roles. The next is regarding an initiative called GOAL or Going Online as Leaders, launched by the Ministry of Tribal Affairs in partnership with Facebook. The GOAL program is designed to provide mentorship in tribal youth through digital mode. The digitally enabled program envisages to act as a catalyst to explore hidden talents of the tribal youth, which will help in their personal development as well as contribute to all-round upliftment of the society. The program intends to upskill and empower 5,000 tribal youths in the current phase to harness the full potential of digital platforms and tools to learn new ways of doing business, explore and connect with the domestic and international markets. Next is regarding the measures to prevent dengue issued by the Health Ministry. So what are the guidelines provided? Surroundings must be kept clean to protect oneself from the mosquito bites as the disease is spread through the mosquitoes. Stagnation of water in containers must be avoided to prevent a mosquito breeding. Coolers must be checked and cleaned on weekly basis. Water tanks and containers must be covered with tight lids. People should use mosquito nets or repellents and long-sleeved clothes to escape from mosquito bites. The water in flower vases, aquariums and bird baths must be changed every week. This slide provides the details of dengue fever. Those who want can pause the video and read. The next is regarding the discovery of a rare super-Earth planet in the center of galaxy. Scientists from the University of Canterbury, or UC, have discovered a rare new super-Earth planet that lies towards the center of the galaxy, also called the galactic bulge. According to the researchers, the planet's host star is about 10% of the mass of our sun. The super-Earth planet's mass would be somewhere between that of Earth and Neptune and would orbit it at a location between Venus and Earth from the parent star. The planet was discovered using a technique called gravitational microlensing, where the combined gravity of the planet and its host star causes light from a more distant background star to be magnified in a particular manner. This slide provides the details of extrasolar planets or exoplanets, like the planet we just discussed. All of the planets in our solar system orbit around the sun. Those planets that orbit around other stars are called extrasolar planets or exoplanets. They are very hard to see directly with the telescopes as they are hidden by the bright glare of the stars they orbit. So astronomers use the other ways to detect and study these distant planets. They search for exoplanets by looking at the effects these planets have on the stars they orbit. So that's all for today, guys. Now, Race to IAS has opened the admission process to a new batch of foundation course for school and college students. The details are provided in the description box and you can check it out now. We are now presenting before you NewsUp, an exciting quiz competition based on our daily news. The quiz presents before you an opportunity to win exciting prizes along with reading your daily newspaper. All you have to do is to go to Race to IAS website and register your name there. Any student studying in the standard 6 to 12 can participate in the program. Duration of the quiz will be 5 minutes between 8 to 9 p.m. from Monday to Friday. There will be no quiz on Saturday and Sunday. So all of you go to Race to IAS website now itself and register your names and participate in the quiz program. And in this way, you can make this lockdown period much more fun and productive. Don't forget to hit the like, share and subscribe buttons if you haven't already. You can also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok and Hilo to get our regular updates. The links are provided in the description box below. Also, download our Junior IAS app from Play Store for daily current affairs, mock tests and quizzes. We'll meet again next week. Until then, stay safe guys. Goodbye.